Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
We would like to give a big, warm welcome to His Holiness Bhakti Caru Maharaj. So just briefly, the schedule of events. Marge is going to speak now. And I think we may be interspersing Maharaj's lecture with some bhajans. And so if that happens, we've got some song sheets we'll pass out to everybody. And Maharaj will speak for the next, hopefully, couple of hours. And then after that, we'll get up and we'll do a nice aarti for the deities, have a little kirtan, and we'll take prasadam. So without further ado, we'll turn the mic over to Maharaj. And again, if he, okay, so Maharaj has a few very rustic bhajans that he has chosen to sing on this day. He's going to speak some nice little guitar, and then we'll do some bhajans at the appropriate time, so everybody should join in enthusiastically.
Om Abhyana Timirandhasya Yenanjana Shalakaya Chukshurun Militam Jena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Shri Chaitanya Mano Krishna Thapitam Yena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Kadamaiham Dadati Swapadamaiham Bandeham Shri Guru Shri Juta Padukamalam Shri Guru Nanda Vaishnavascha Shri Rupam Sagrajatam Sahagana Raghunathan Ritantam Sajivam Sattvaitam Savadhutam Parijana Sahitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam Shri Radha Krishna Pada Sahagana Lalita Shri Vishakha Nitamascha Ajanu Lambito Pujo Kanakavadato Sankirtanaita Pitaro Kamalayatakshu Vishambharo Dijogaro Jugadharma Palo Bande Jagat Priyakaro Koruna Dotaro He Krishna Koruna Sindho Dina Bandho Jagat Pate Gopesha Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namastute Tapta Kanchana Gaurangi Radhe Vrindavaneshwari Vrishabhano Sute Devi Pranamami Hari Priya Vancha Kalpa Tarubhascha Kripa Sindhu Bhayevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha. Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadha Shri Vashani Govardhanavrinda Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare
Hare. Hare Krishna. So today is the chip rice and yogurt festival that took place about 500 years ago. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu already took sannyas and left Navadvip and went to Jagannath Puri. Nityananda Prabhu wanted to be with Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in Jagannath Puri. But Chaitanya Mahaprabhu instructed him to go back to Bengal in order to spread Krishna consciousness. And it is under Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Srimad Nityananda Prabhu's wonderful guidance and mercy that Krishna consciousness was spreading in Bengal at that time. It has been described that Nityananda Prabhu came to inundate the whole of Bengal, Laguna Beach. And those who are fortunate, they got submerged in that flood of Krishna fame. They drowned in that Krishna flame, love of Krishna. But those who are not fortunate, those who are not so devoted, those who did not accept Krishna consciousness so readily, they got swept in that flood. And no one could escape that mercy that Nityananda Prabhu came to inundate Bengal with. Krishna consciousness was spreading most wonderfully at that time. Many people became devotees of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Many of them, of course, were
Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's eternal associates. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is Krishna himself. Towards the end of Dwapar Yuga, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Krishna revealed his Vrindavan pastime, and those associates of Krishna also came with Sri Krishna when he appeared in the age of Kali as Sri Krishna Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Krishna, in the mood of Srimati Radharani and assuming the complexion of Srimati Radharani, is Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. There is no difference between Krishna and Sri Krishna Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. The difference is only of mood. The Supreme Personality of Godhead assumed the mood of a devotee, assumed the mood of the best of all devotees, Srimati Radharani. So Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, with the mood of Srimati Radharani, when he descended in the age of Kali, in the land of Gaura Mandala Bhumi, which is known as Bengal, he came with his eternal associates as well. Krishna's associates came also in Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's pastime. Among the associates, many of them are cowherd boys. And the leader of those cowherd boys is Nityananda Prabhu. So when Nityananda Prabhu was spreading Krishna consciousness, Nityananda Prabhu was preaching in Bengal, those cowherd boys also, who appeared in these pastimes, gathered around him. And many of them became very actively involved in Nityananda Prabhu's preaching mission. And in that area of Bengal, the most important place at that time was Saptagram, which was the port of Bengal, in the confluence of three rivers. Just as Ganga, Jamuna and Saraswati unites in Prayag, in this part of Bengal also these three rivers combine together, and the most important person of that area, who was actually, one can say, the king of that area, who was the father of Raghunath Das Goswami, a very, very exalted family, very wealthy. Their monthly, or rather their annual income was 1.2 million rupees those days. Now, if we calculate in today's calculation, it will amount to few million dollars. Like if we consider the amount of gold that one could buy with that money, and if we make the equivalent of that, then we will see that their income was few million dollars every year. They were the most aristocratic family, the most opulent family, and Nityananda Prabhu, Raghunath Das Goswami, was the only son, only male member of that family. So, Raghunath Das Goswami became affected by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's influence. He got to know about Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and he became a devotee of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And he wanted to be with Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu all the time. Actually, when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu took sannyas, then Nityananda Prabhu misdirected him and brought him back to Shantipur. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, after taking sannyas, wanted to go to Vrindavan. Right after taking sannyas, he was running to go to Vrindavan. But Nityananda Prabhu knew how the residents of Navadvip were feeling due to Mahaprabhu's sudden acceptance of sannyas. How heartbroken everyone was. So Nityananda Prabhu tricked Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and brought him to Shantipur. The other side, Shantipur is in one side of Ganges, and on the other side of the Ganges is Karna, Ambika Karna. And Nityananda Prabhu brought Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to that place on the other side of the bank of the river from Shantipur. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Nityananda Prabhu told some cowherd boys there that when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu would come and ask them what is this place, they should tell him that this is Vrindavan. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, losing his external consciousness, he was running, and he ran for quite some time from Kathua, where he took sannyas, and Nityananda Prabhu brought him to this place. And in the meantime, he sent somebody to inform Advaita Acharya to come to the other side of the river from Shantipur with a boat and some dry cloth. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, when he was running, he saw these cowherd boys tending the cows, and they became very, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu became very much affected by that sight. And he wanted, his remembrance of Vrindavan dawned in his heart. And he wondered, is this Vrindavan? The cowherd boys and the cows. And he asked the boys, and the boys replied, yes, this is Vrindavan. And then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu asked Nityananda Prabhu, Nityananda, we came to Vrindavan. And Nityananda Prabhu said, yes, we came to Vrindavan, there is Jamuna. He pointed to Ganga and said, that is Jamuna. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, losing his, already he was in the mood of Vrindavan, everywhere he was seeing Vrindavan, and he did not have his external consciousness. So he ran to the river and plunged into Ganga. And in the meantime, Advaita Acharya, he was waiting with the boat. So he came there and he came to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and asked him to come onto the boat. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu asked him, how come you are here? Advaita, how did you come to Vrindavan? Advaita Acharya said, well, I just came from the other side of the river to meet you here. And then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu realized that it was actually, he had been tricked. He didn't go to Vrindavan, he is on the other side of Shantipur, on the bank of the Ganges. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu became very upset with Nityananda Prabhu. He said, why did you lie to me? You said that this is Vrindavan, and you said this is Jamuna. Nityananda Prabhu said, no, I didn't lie. Because wherever you are, that is Vrindavan. And it is understood, or the fact is, that when Ganga and Jamuna merged in Triveni, then Jamuna is flowing on the left hand side and Ganga is flowing on the right hand side of the river. So since this is the left hand side of the river, so this is Jamuna. So not that, about this also I like to hear. Anyway, then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was taken to Shantipur by Advaita Acharya, and the residents of Navadvip Mayapur were informed that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has arrived in Shantipur. So all the residents of Navadvip came to see Sri Chaitanya. The whole of Shantipur became filled with millions of people who actually wanted to see Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And Raghunath Das Goswami also came. He was very keen to meet Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He heard about Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu but didn't have the opportunity to meet him. So Raghunath Das Goswami arrived there, and since he was the son of a very important person, Advaita Acharya was reported that Raghunath Das Goswami came, and Raghunath Das Goswami was immediately brought to Advaita Acharya, because Advaita Acharya was patronized by Raghunath Das Goswami's father and uncle. So they had a very close relationship. So Raghunath Das Goswami was taken to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu by Advaita Acharya, and he was also given the remnants of Sri Chaitanya. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu had some very sweet exchanges with Raghunath Das Goswami. Raghunath Das Goswami expressed his desire to go with Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He told him that, I don't want to stay at home. I simply want to be with you. Please allow me also to travel with you. Then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told Raghunath Das Goswami that there is no need to display false renunciation, monkey renunciation. Just go home and accept whatever is favorable to Krishna consciousness, and with a mood of detachment, you just render your duty. And in your heart, you cultivate your Krishna consciousness. And in due course of time, Krishna will bestow your mercy upon you. So in this way, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu discouraged Raghunath Das Goswami and sent him back home. Then Raghunath Das Goswami, being instructed by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in this way, went back home, but his heart was not at home. He always wanted to be with Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So deep was his love. And Raghunath Das Goswami, in his original identity, was one of the eternal associates of Sri Krishna. He is one of the manjaris in this bhava. One of the young girls who assists Srimati Radharani in our pastimes with Krishna. So naturally, Raghunath Das Goswami's deep attachment to Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu became manifest. And Raghunath Das Goswami, although he was the son of a very, very rich person, and he was the successor to the dynasty. There was no other male member in the family. So naturally, everything was actually meant for him. But still, Raghunath Das Goswami was not interested in all that material opulence. It has been described that Raghunath Das Goswami's opulence was like that of Indra, the king of heaven. But Raghunath Das Goswami was not interested in that material situation, although it was extremely opulent. And Raghunath Das Goswami from time to time tried to run away from home and go to Jagannath Puri, where Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was residing. But each time he would run away, his father would send the soldiers, his men, to catch him and bring him back. When he was running away like that, then they became so concerned, they were planning how to keep him involved in their family affairs. So they got him married to a girl, to a princess who was as beautiful as an apsara, as a resident of heavenly planet. And Raghunath Das Goswami, in spite of getting married, but still he was not interested in his family life. Still he was trying to run away. Then one day he got the news that Nityananda Prabhu came to Panihati, the place which was not too far from Shaptagram, from the place where Raghunath Das Goswami used to reside. Raghunath Das Goswami got the news that Nityananda Prabhu came to Panihati and he was staying in the house of Raghav Pandit. Raghav Pandit is another very intimate associate of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Nityananda Prabhu. So Nityananda Prabhu came and he was staying in the house of Raghav Pandit. So Raghunath Das Goswami took this opportunity. At that time, he was constantly being guarded. Like wherever he went, the bodyguards were guarding him. So with the permission of his parents, he came to Panihati to meet Nityananda Prabhu. At that time, Nityananda Prabhu was sitting under a banyan tree on the bank of the river Ganges, surrounded by his associates. And Raghunath Das Goswami, from a distance, offered his obeisances. One of Nityananda Prabhu's associates informed to Nityananda Prabhu that Raghunath is offering you obeisances. So Nityananda Prabhu then told him that, where is that thief? As soon as he heard about Raghunath Das Goswami, he addressed him as a thief. So they pointed out that Raghunath is there. He said, bring him here. So they brought Raghunath Das Goswami to Nityananda. Raghunath Das Goswami fell at his feet. And Nityananda Prabhu told him that this thief must be punished. I must give him punishment. And he gave him a wonderful punishment. The punishment was that Raghunath Das Goswami had to feed Nityananda Prabhu and his associates with chipped rice and yogurt. So that happened about 500 years ago, about 400 some years ago. And today we are actually celebrating that festival. So I'll get into that describing, but before that, before we get into describing the festival, we will sing one paragraph from the Shat Goswami Ashtakam, the 8 verses that glorify the 6 Goswamis of the Maya: Rupa Goswami, Sanatan Goswami, Raghunath Das Goswami, Raghunath Bhatta Goswami, Sri Jiva Goswami, and Gopal Bhatta Goswami. So this is the 4th stanza of the 8 verses of 4th of the 8 verses of Shat Goswami Ashtakam. Did everybody get the song copies? Okay, I will need one. So, as I mentioned earlier, that Raghunath Das Goswami was from an extremely opulent family. And not only Raghunath Das Goswami, but practically all the 6 Goswamis were coming from a very, very opulent and exalted background. Like Rupa Goswami and Sanatan Goswami were the ministers of the king of Bengal at that time. And Jiva Goswami was the nephew. Raghunath Bhatta Goswami and Gopal Bhatta Goswami also came from very exalted Brahminical families. And among them, Raghunath Das Goswami was the most opulent. And Srila Prabhupada pointed out that through Raghunath Das Goswami, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu taught us the way of renunciation. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came to teach Vairagya Vidya. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came to teach the science of renunciation, which is Nija Bhakti Yoga, his own devotion. And Raghunath Das Goswami was his model through whom he taught the science of renunciation. That, if we have time, we'll discuss afterwards. So, we will sing this one stanza from Shat Goswami Ashtakam. Takta Turnam Ashesha Mandala Prati Shreni Sada Tuchabas Bhutva Dina Ganesha Kau Karunaya Kaupina Kantha Shrita Gopi Bhava Rasam Ritabhi Lakari Kallolo Magno Mukur Bande Rupa Sanatanam Raghu Jugau Shri Jiva Gopalakam. I offer my respectful obeisances unto the 6 Goswamis, namely Shri Rupa Goswami, Shri Sanatan Goswami, Shri Raghunath Bhatta Goswami, Shri Raghunath Das Goswami, Shri Jiva Goswami, and Sri Gopal Bhatta Goswami, who kicked off all association of unlimited kings and monarchs as insignificant, In order to deliver the poor conditioned souls, they accepted loincloth, treating themselves as mendicants, but they are always merged in the ecstatic ocean of the gopis' love for Krishna and bathe always in the waves of that ocean. So although they came from very, very opulent and aristocratic background, but in order to bestow their mercy upon the conditioned suffering souls, they accepted the lives of renunciates, all six of them. They accepted Kopina Kanthashita. Kopin means loincloth, and Kantha is few pieces of cloths are stitched together. You can say it's a kind of a cheap blanket to protect themselves from the cold of winter. All that they did in order to bestow their mercy and compassion upon the fallen conditioned soul.
Oh,
Unto the six Goswamis, namely Sri Rupa Goswami, Sri Sanatan Goswami, Sri Raghunath Das Goswami, Sri Raghunath Bhatta Goswami, Sri Jiva Goswami, and Sri Gopal Bhatta Goswami, who kicked off all association of unlimited kings and monarchs as insignificant. In order to deliver the poor conditioned souls, they accepted loincloths, treating themselves as mendicants. But they are always merged in the ocean of in the ecstatic ocean of gopis' love for Krishna, and bathe always in the waves of that ocean. So Raghunath Das Goswami is one of the six Goswamis. And although he was the son of an extremely wealthy father, but when he became attracted to Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he lost all interest of his material opulence. And when he met Nityananda Prabhu, Nityananda Prabhu addressed him as a thief. Now why Nityananda Prabhu addressed him as a thief? So that has been explained as Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is actually the wealth of Nityananda Prabhu. Hano Nitai Vine Bhai Radha Krishna Paike. If we want Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, who is Radha Krishna, the combined form of Radha Krishna, we have to approach him through Nityananda Prabhu, because he is the asset, he is the possession of Nityananda. So without Nityananda Prabhu's mercy, one cannot get Sri Chaitanya. Now Raghunath Das Goswami, all this while, was trying to get Chaitanya Mahaprabhu directly. He was approaching Chaitanya Mahaprabhu directly. Therefore, Nityananda Prabhu considered him a thief. And the punishment he gave him for that crime was that he'll have to feed everybody, Nityananda Prabhu and his associates, with chira, chipped rice, or flat rice, and yogurt. And Raghunath Das Goswami accepted that punishment with an ecstatic heart. He became very, very joyful to get this punishment, that this opportunity that he got to serve Nityananda Prabhu and his devotees. And Raghunath Das Goswami immediately made the arrangements that has been very beautifully described in Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita. And Raghunath Das Goswami had his men with him. So he sent them to make the arrangements to buy lots of all the cheap rice they could buy from the market and the yogurt they could buy from the market. And not only cheap rice and yogurt, he arranged to buy condensed milk and all kinds of fruits that were available. At this time of the year in India, especially in Bengal, you get lots of fruits, especially mango, jackfruit, and various other such delicious fruits grow in summer in India. So he got all these, arranged all the fruits. And in the meantime, the news reached all around that Raghunath Das Goswami is buying up all the commodities that one was bringing, the sweets and milk products. So all these people started to come with their commodity to sell. And Raghunath Das Goswami bought everything. And he arranged the festival. The chip rice and yogurt was mixed together with bananas and mango pulp and jackfruit juice with sugar. The sugar in Bengal, or sugar in India those days, used to be made out of crystallizing the sugar, not the sugar that one gets nowadays. That was not the sugar we used those days. They were crystallized sugar. They used to become in big crystals called bichri or shortcoda khandha. And also another, anyway, various kinds of sugar was used to sweeten that. And another preparation was made with flaked rice called khoi and condensed milk. And plus there were sweets, and the arrangement was made to serve this chip rice and yogurt and condensed milk and flaked rice mixed with different kinds of sweets and fruit juice. And Nityananda Prabhu and his associates were served with that. And whoever came at that time, they also were served this prasad. And the place became filled with thousands of people. That place became so full that there was no place left in the land portion. So people actually went to the river, and half submerged in the river they were taking that prasad. The prasad was served in clay pot, and it has been described that even those who came to sell their commodities, they were also given the prasad. And the news spread that big feast is being organized by Raghunath Das Goswami. Whoever is coming is getting the, is allowed to participate, or rather invited to take part. So hearing that, many people came. So in this way, the whole, it was a massive feast organized by Raghunath Das Goswami. And at that time, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu invited, Nityananda Prabhu invited Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came from Jagannath. Some could see and some couldn't see. And Nityananda Prabhu went to everybody, especially his associates, and he took a handful and offered it first to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and then he took himself. In this way, Nityananda Prabhu along with Chaitanya Mahaprabhu went to every single person there, and he fed from their plate to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and he himself ate that prasad. Now, that festival is celebrated in Panihati still today, and since last 15-20 years, ISKCON is actually organizing this feast and festival. And previously, before ISKCON actually got involved, that festival became just people used to come, but this acceptance or distribution of chipped rice and yogurt, the feast part of it was practically lost, because nobody wanted to spend money. And whenever some individuals arranged some sort of distribution of chipped rice and yogurt, did it in a very, very insignificant way. But then since ISKCON got involved, that festival has taken an incredible shape. Now, we serve about 50,000 people come, and all these 50,000 people get prasad, and the prasad is distributed. This chipped rice, yogurt, we make it according to that standard. Like one portion is chipped rice and yogurt, and the other portion is condensed milk and khoi, which is called flaked rice in Bengal, mixed with different types of fruit juices, and we serve that to all the people that come. About 50,000. And distribution goes on from morning till night, because it's not easy to feed 50,000 people. Even to distribute, it takes a lot of time. And so in this way we can see that ISKCON is actually reviving Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's movement. All the festivities that mark Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Nityananda Prabhu's pastimes are being enacted and revived by ISKCON today, even in the land of Golamandala, in the land of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So, in this way, Nityananda Prabhu bestowed his mercy through this punishment. And then we see Raghunath Das Goswami, who could not actually escape from home previously. After this incident, Raghunath Das Goswami succeeded in escaping and going, and he went to Jagannath Puri and was accepted by Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So before we, in this way we can see that without Nityananda Prabhu's mercy, one cannot actually approach Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Hano Nitai Vine Bhai Radha Krishna Paitena. One cannot get this Radha Krishna, who appeared in the form of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, without the mercy of Nityananda Prabhu. Because Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is the property of Nityananda Prabhu. And Nityananda Prabhu is the original spiritual master, Balaram. So Radha Krishna is, Krishna is actually Balaram's prophet. And in this pastime, Krishna appeared as Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Balaram appeared as Nityananda. So it is by the mercy of Nityananda Prabhu that one can get Sri Chaitanya. So if we want Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's mercy, then first we have to receive the mercy of Nityananda Prabhu, the original spiritual master. So now we can, in glorification of Nityananda Prabhu, we can sing one stanza from Nityananda Ashtaka. It goes like, Sharat Chandra Bhantim Spurad Amala Kantim Gajagotim Harit Premon Mastam Dhrita Parama Sattam Smita Mukham Shada Bhurna Netram Paro Kolita Vetram Koli Hidam Bhaje Nityanandam Bhajana Toru Khandam Miravati. This is the first stanza of the Nityananda Ashtakam. It says that Nityananda Prabhu's brilliant complexion makes the radiance of the full moon feel embarrassed. And his movement is like the king of elephants. He is always in transcendental madness due to his love for Sri Krishna, Hari. And he is always situated, and his personality is in transcendental goodness, and his face is radiant with a beautiful smile. His eyes are constantly rotating. Shada Bhurna Netram and Karo Kolita Vetram. In his hand there is a stick, and he removes the ill effects, evil effects of the age of Kali. I worship and serve with all the love of my heart to this Nityananda Prabhu, who is the trunk of the tree of bhakti, and who is the trunk of the tree of devotional service.
Thank you.
Nityananda Prabhu came to distribute his mercy. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's appearance is very special. Krishna, in no other incarnation, displayed this kind of mercy. In other incarnation, Krishna comes to Paritranaya Sadhana and Vinashaya Chatuskutam. Krishna comes to protect his devotees and to annihilate the miscreants. But in no other incarnation Krishna went out of his way to distribute Krishna prema. And Nityananda Prabhu himself revealed that fact to Srila Jiva Goswami, another member of the six principal Goswami, who was the nephew of Rupa Goswami and Sanatana Goswami. Jiva Goswami was a little boy when his uncles and father left home and went to Vrindavan. They met Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Actually, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu went to the place where they used to live, a place in northern part of Bengal which was the capital of Bengal at that time, and in a place called Ramkeli, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself went to meet Rupa Goswami and Sanatana Goswami on his way to Vrindavan. Rupa Goswami and Sanatana Goswami wrote to Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu expressing their intense urge to surrender themselves unto him. And in a very humble mood, they expressed their inability and disqualification. Their inability and disqualification, they considered, were that although they were born in a very exalted Brahminical family, but they were forced to accept the service of the Muslim king of Bengal at that time, Hussein Shah. It is not that they volunteered or they went and sought the position from him, but Hussein Shah, when got to know about their brilliance, Hussein Shah wanted them to become his ministers. Rupa Goswami and Sanatana Goswami hailed from a very, very exalted Brahmana family. And those days, the Hindu society was so strict, especially the Brahmanas, that if one had anything to do with the Muslims, they used to be ostracized. So, when Rupa Goswami and Sanatana Goswami were forced to or had to accept the job as the minister, as the ministers of King Hussein Shah, the Muslim king of Bengal at that time, the Brahmana community actually ostracized them. But still, Rupa Goswami and Sanatana Goswami maintained their Brahminical culture and their Brahminical activities. But still, at the depth of their heart, they must have felt some sort of discontentment and disappointment. Now, to give an example, why they were forced to join the king as the minister was because this Hussein Shah was a very tyrannical person. He was a tyrant. If somebody did not accept his order, then he would go to any extent to punish those people. To give an example, Hussein Shah, after conquering some country, he built a tower, a very big tower, as a symbol of his victory. And the architect, after the thing was completed, after the tower was completed, the architect was showing Hussein Shah. He took him up to the tower, on top of the tower, and he was showing. And Hussein Shah at that time detected some mistake, some architectural defect in the construction. So he just picked up the architect and threw him from the top of the tower. So when he heard about Rupa Goswami and Sanatana Goswami's brilliant personalities, he wanted them to become his ministers and send his message. And Rupa Goswami and Sanatana Goswami consulted with other members of the family and their well-wishers and friends. And everyone advised them, don't go against the king. We'll be in trouble. All of us will be in trouble. So please accept his offer. So they accepted the offer, and they became Rupa. Sanatana Goswami became the prime minister of the king. And Rupa Goswami became the finance minister. So these two brothers actually held two most important positions of the King of Bengal at the time. And in a very humble mood, they wrote to Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in Jagannath Puri that they are so fallen. Now he came to deliver the fallen soul. So wouldn't he bestow his mercy upon them? And when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu received that message, he considered to come and deliver them. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came to Ramkeli, the village where they lived, and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu met with them. And after that meeting, Sanatana Goswami and first Rupa Goswami, he left home and went to Vrindavan according to the instruction of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And Sanatana Goswami also soon followed him. So, at that time Jiva Goswami was a little boy, and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu actually placed his lotus feet on the head of this little boy Jiva Goswami. And it is said that by doing that, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu actually coronated Jiva Goswami as the monarch of the Vaishnava community of that time, or in the future. When Jiva Goswami grew up, he also left home. He wanted to go to Vrindavan to meet his uncle. And on the way, he stopped in Navadvip. At that time, Nityananda Prabhu was there. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu already withdrew his pastime. And Nityananda Prabhu took Jiva Goswami in a parikrama of Navadvip. And after showing all the places of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's pastimes, Nityananda Prabhu sat down with Jiva Goswami and he revealed the fact why Krishna appears as Sri Krishna Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He explained that after revealing his Vrindavan pastime, Krishna considered that although he revealed his Braja Leela, although he revealed his Vrindavan pastimes, where devotees get an opportunity to develop or be related to him in friendship, parental and conjugal relationship, which is not otherwise possible to develop with the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu considered, how will anyone ever be able to come to Vrindavan or enter into Vrindavan and develop this relationship? Because these three relationships are impossible for anyone to develop, like to become the friend of the Supreme Personality of God, to become the father and mother, the parents of the Supreme Personality of God, or to become the lover of the Supreme Personality of God. These three relationships with the Supreme Personality of Godhead are available only in Vrindavan. Nowhere else these relationships are possible. In Vaikuntha, in the spiritual world, in the spiritual sky, these three relationships are not available. In Vaikuntha, everyone is related to the Supreme Personality of Godhead as his servants, or in the mood of neutrality, Shanta and Dasya. But Vishakha, Vatsalya and Madhur, these three mellows are not possible, is not available in Vaikuntha, and is not possible to develop in Vaikuntha. So Krishna considered that my devotees will serve me according to Vaidhi Bhakti. And by serving me in Vaidhi Bhakti, by developing their devotion unto me, following the rules and regulations of the scriptures, when they will attain their perfection, they will be elevated to Vaikuntha. So how will then anyone be able to come to Vrindavan? Because the devotees will serve Krishna in Vaidhi Bhakti all the time. Without following the rules and regulations, devotional service cannot be rendered. Devotional service must be rendered by following the rules and regulations of the scripture. It is said that if devotional service, even sincere, earnest devotional service is rendered without following the instructions of the scriptures, vidhi, then it will simply create a disturbance in the society. Shruti, Smriti, Puranadi, Pancharatra, Vidhin, Vina, Oikantiki, Harer, Bhakti, Utpatoi, Gopalpati. Shruti, Sriti, Puran, Adi. Without following the instructions of the Vedas, Upanishads, Puran, if one renders devotional service, Oikantiki Harer Bhakti. Oikantiki means very, very sincere and earnest. If one sincerely, earnestly renders devotional service unto Krishna, without following the injunctions and the instructions of the scriptures, will simply create a disturbance in the society. So the devotees will render devotional service following Vaidhi Bhakti, and by doing that, when they attain their perfection, they will go to Vaikuntha. Because Vaidhi Bhakti leads to Vaikuntha. So how will anyone be able to come to Vrindavan? Therefore, Krishna decided to come as a devotee. And when one renders devotional service unto the devotee, following the Vaidhi Bhakti, then the doors to Vrindavan becomes wide open. So in this way, in order to enable the living entities to enter into Vrindavan, Krishna appeared as a devotee, Krishna Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And this devotee Krishna is served according to the instructions of the scriptures in a very special way. Like as we mentioned earlier, the Supreme Personality of Godhead or devotional service must be executed by following the rules and regulations of the scriptures. We can never disregard the rules and regulations of the scriptures. Now what are the scriptures saying about serving this devotee Krishna? Jagai Sankirtana Prayoya Jajanti Hismeha. Krishna Varnam, Tishat Krishna, Sangha Pangastra Parshadam, Jaggai Sankirtana Praye, Jajanti Sumedha. When Krishna appeared, assuming the complexion of Srimati Radharani, the molten golden complexion, a non-Krishna complexion, chanting the names of Krishna all the time, when he appears along with his associates and entourage, along with his abode and along with his weapon, he introduces a very special type of yajna called Sankirtan. Jaggai Sankirtana Praya and Jajanti Hi Sumedhasa. That Supreme Personality of Godhead is served through Sankirtan. Sankirtan means the congregational chanting of the holy name of the Lord. Sankirtan means the collective glorification of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Sankirtan means engaging everything for the sake of glorifying the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Sankirtan means accepting every opportunity and every means to propagate the mercy of the Supreme Personality of God. So this personality, devotee Krishna, Sri Krishna Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, is served through this Sankirtan Yajna. That is the meaning of the scriptures. So when this Supreme Personality of Godhead as a devotee is served through Sankirtan, then the gate of Vrindavan becomes wide open to him. How? Because this Supreme Personality of Godhead as a devotee is actually Radha and Krishna together. So when one attains the perfection of his devotion unto him, then he sees this Chaitanya Mahaprabhu as Radha Krishna. Shri Krishna Chaitanya, Radha Krishna Nahima. This Krishna Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is none other than Radha and Krishna. So at the time of the ultimate perfection of rendering service to Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, one actually sees him as Radha and Krishna. And when one sees him as Radha Krishna, that is Vrindavan. That is enables him to enter into Vrindavan. So this is the way that Krishna devised. This is the means that Krishna has arranged for a living entity to enter into his Vrindavan pastime. One serves Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in Dasya Rasa, following the vidhi of the scripture, serving him as a in the mood of servitorship. But this servitorship to Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu enables one to enter into Vrindavan, where he listens to his prayer. Tahar prarthana shune shunanda.
Rupo Sanatana Pade Dante Trinakori, falling at the feet of Srila Rupa Goswami and Sanatana Goswami with straw in his mouth. Bhakti Vinoda Pade Duhu Pade Dhori. Bhakti Vinod Thakur, falling at their feet, holding on to their lotus feet, saying, Kadia Kadia Bale Amito Athan. With tears in his eyes, crying piteously, he says, I am so fallen, I am the most fallen. Shikhai Sharanagati Karohe Untam. Teaching me the process of surrender or Sharanagati, please elevate me to the platform of devotional service. Shri Krishna Chaitanya Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu.
Thank you.
Falling at the feet of Srila Rupa Goswami and Sanatan Goswami with straw in his mouth, Bhakti Vinoda Pade Duhu Pade Dhori. Bhakti Vinod Thakur, falling at their feet, holding on to their lotus feet, saying, Kadiya Kadiya Pade Amito Athan, with tears in his eyes, crying piteously. He says, I am so fallen, I am the most fallen. Shikhai Sharanagati Karohe Untam. Teaching me the process of surrender or Sharanagati, please elevate me to the platform of devotional service. Shri Krishna Chaitanya
Thank you. Thank you. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna,